all you critters, what's up? I am Wayward Dreams, and I am back with a little speed paint for you. I've got my sake in front of me, so let's play, shall we? Alright, so this is CipherCat. CipherCat is my little cyberpunk alter ego, and she's kind of an ever-evolving little form of mine. I never quite settled on exactly how she looks, so I like to play with it sometimes. I like drawing her because I can pretty much put myself into any situation I want. She can be just as badass or as adorable or as awesome as I would love to be, but can't be because I'm pretty much just a stay-at-home artist these days. I'm going to tell you a little bit about why I love cyberpunk so much, and why I love it is the same reason why I'm afraid of it. I like the dystopic stories, because in a far-off future where you've got this sharp contrast between machines and people, and humanity's struggle and resistance against essentially the machine, whether that's actual machines or the machine of the corporation and where it places you as a citizen, whether you are somebody that lives in something bright and shiny and full of neon, or if you're in the dregs and you're just looking at the neon in the distance. It's really the story of humans, far less than it is the story of the technology. And while the technology is there, it serves as a relief. It serves as a contrast to flesh and blood and the human soul. And I guess that's why I have always been fascinated with futuristic dystopian sort of stuff, is what humanity does, and also it's just visual candy as far as I can see it. The other reason I started this is I suppose she gets to stand out there as my little statement, and the statement is I've been trying really, really hard not to get into anything that has to do with politics, that has to do with what's going on in the world, except for maybe a couple of small social commentaries. But my belief right now, watching so many people get censored and watching so many people talk about how, you know, we should start outlawing some forms of speech, it's just, it's appalling to me. It's appalling because I have goth punker roots. You guys need to watch Pump the Volume if you haven't. But in all seriousness, it feels like people have taken the clothing of the people that came before them and carried this rebellious nature, and they've taken that uniform and they've used it to say that people need to have their voice taken away. And I'm not saying that I like anything to do with hateful speech. I don't like it, but let the idiots talk, okay? If the idiot is going to hang himself, the idiot is going to hang himself. But that doesn't mean that we should all throw ourselves on the blade of chaining this great beast of free speech and then handing those chains over to the government. It feels like a part of us has been betrayed, almost. Like, and I'm gonna say it, it feels like my roots have been culturally appropriated. Ha 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 ha. But they have been. By people that look like punks, that will not fight for our voice to be heard. And you know what? We may have been wrong back in the day, but it didn't necessarily mean that we would ever stand for our voices to be taken. And that was the point of things like Serenity, and the point of things like Pump the Volume and Hackers. So yeah, her little sign back there that she graffitied says freedom of information, if you're too young to figure that one out. And the anarchy symbol, even though I myself am not personally an anarchist, I think it's a rather immature way to deal with things. But minimal government and, you know, allowing people to be and allowing social discourse to take its place, it makes sure that, you know, if there's a jerk or an asshole, we can see them coming because they spoke, and we find like-minded individuals this way. Trust me, if there's an actual Nazi about to do an actual lynching of somebody, I will stand right up and stop it. and I will expect everyone else to do the same. But accusing everybody and trying to use this as leverage to shut people up, you have no idea when that beast that just got chained is going to be used against you. It's not going to continue to be used in your favor. They are using this so that they can eventually have it all. And when, oh my god, when is it hate speech against the government? As far as I'm concerned, I'm gonna keep my big curl panties on, and I am never, ever, and you should not let it either. I am never letting my children become unarmed cannon fodder that cannot speak out against the wrongdoings of the people that control our country. And if you have a hard time believing that somebody saying something mean on Twitter trumps that, then I'm gonna tell you right now, you are no punk. Go back to the roots, find out what it is, be loud, be proud, never stop talking. Because if you have anything on this world to say, you cannot stop using your voice. And I don't care who you are and what your views are, don't stop. And for God's sake, never, ever, ever think that it's all right for you, in your infinite wisdom, to try and be the judge of whose voice gets taken. Because yours, you best believe it, yours is going to be next. Now keep in mind, when I say you and yours, I'm really not picking at one person in particular and saying you are or you do. This is a message to the out, as it were. Because it's too important. You can never let them stop the signal. We have to keep the most sacred thing to us, and the most sacred thing to us is the ability to voice our opinions, to make changes, and to make sure that we are keeping tyranny in check. So there it is. That's why I am a cyberpunk geek, because I look down the barrel of the future and I can see the censorship coming. I can see what's going to happen. I can feel the dregs coming. And it's not going to be pretty unless you keep your head up and unless you keep your principles close to your heart. I'm Wayward Dreams. This has been my little rant. I hope that you understand what I mean by all of this. You can always find me on DeviantArt, Twitter, and Instagram. We'll see you next time.
And unwilling to witness or permit the slow undoing of those human rights. We dare not forget today that we are the heirs of that first revolution. In a new alliance for progress, to convert our good words into good deeds.